Evil Cauldron Witch. Let's talk about it. Here we have my Spirit Halloween exclusive Evil Cauldron Witch, and I just don't know why that's. Let's see, oh, okay. So she is from 2009 in store, 2010 to 2012 online only. Her retail price was $129. She's approximately, when risen, 4 feet. Made by Techie Designs. She's out of stock. And, all right, guys, so let's take a closer look at her. So first I'll talk about how I got her. So I got her off of Facebook, and I saw a yard sale listing, and she was hidden in the background. And I asked the guy if they still had her, and they did. And I came, I believe, the next day and picked her up. She is super awesome and super cool. I got her for an amazing price. I don't even want to say how much I got her for, because it was such a good price. But let's look at her. Let's look. So she consists of a purple hat with a little green ribbon, and then she has the cauldron. Now this is one of the only, not one of the only, but this is like a Spirit Halloween prop that required no assembly. Pretty much no assembly. I mean, I don't know if you had to put batteries in her or something, but it pretty much required no assembly. There was no poles and snap locking and this and that. Her box was huge, and I do not have her box currently. I never had it, but, and yeah, she's awesome. So let's look at the hat. The hat is purple. It does an amazing job at collecting dust. There's a piece of metal wire in her little pointy hat part, and so you can like bend it up and down and around and all, wherever you want to bend it. It kind of looks like an eagle, to be honest, but that might just be me. Going under here, you can see this is the Creepy Witch. Now, like I said before, she's made by Techie Designs, and she's a pretty old one. She looks really amazing. I love this design. Here, you just gotta trust the process. But she is just so epic. She is just such an amazing prop. I haven't used her yet in my display, but if I do, I am not gonna be using her activated, because she is such a faulty prop. So many people's breaks. So I've resorted to just using batteries and not using her on Halloween, because she would just keep going on and off, and then she might break. So let's take a closer look. Flipping the cauldron around to the backside, indicated by this gaping hole, you can see that if you lift up that nice piece of cloth, you will see that there is the insides, and here is a step pad that works with it. I don't know why it's in there, but you can see in here how she has her base and her riser mech. So the animation on this one is fairly simple. It's just, it rises up, the eyes light up, and then it comes down. It's a very simple animatronic, but still a very cool character. The cloth, the purple cloth, is supposed to be glued around the edges, around here. But when I repaired this character, I unglued it. It has a very simple techie base. This is, you know, the old 2009 quality they had, which was pretty decent, I guess. She takes 4 AA batteries, and her modes are step pad, off, and on. And on is probably like sound sensor. She doesn't have a little normal sensor. Now let's get to a demo of her. I think she has like one or two phrases. She doesn't have many. Let's get to an activation of her. So correction, I think she only has one phrase. I mean, I still could be wrong. They might just be very similar. But you can see that she had her movement's nice and smooth. It's a little loud, but it's an old prop and it's definitely at its age. Now that I have her popped up, we can look at some of her detail. She's got a pretty small face. It's kind of like the size of my hand, but it's a very creepy design. I think it was used on another prop as well. She's got some hands. This is all plastic. Her clothing is just like this like purple material. It's very nostalgic, you know, it's simple. It's not like crazy and designed and dirtied up, but it just looks amazing. It's like this shiny purple plastic. Her hair, she has like the traditional just like old hair. You have to keep in mind, she's so old that like back then this was like really, really amazing. Her eyes are nice, they're cool and painted. They're kind of off-center though. But they're, I can't really do anything about that. She's got some creepy looking teeth, some nice airbrushing around the eyes, nice green. And yeah, let's move to the cauldron now. The cauldron has so much detail. It's something we'll probably never see again, is like a cauldron that is fully blow molded. I'm lying because there's the Home Depot ones, but like, something of this sorts. If this was going to be remade today and maybe like SVI did it or something, or even Techie, they'd probably use like a felt one, because they tend to use felt ones nowadays when it comes to like animatronics with cauldrons and stuff. But this one is like a very big cauldron. The cauldron is just that black plastic that you would find any Halloween cauldron at like Walmart or anything. It's just that plastic. It's pretty thick. This might be a little bit thicker than the normal stuff, but like, it's that type of material. It feels like those cauldrons you could buy at Spirit Halloween. But moving on, you can see the rope has some like little paintbrush strokes making it look dirty. And then it has, I believe, two layers of creepy cloth. One layer, two layer. And it really just makes this prop look wonderful, especially when she's lowered. There's more to look at. As well as there's the creepy cloth that's all nice and worn and ripped and stuff. There's also little bits of like bronze or brown sprayed throughout the cauldron just to add another touch of detail. This prop really had a lot of detail, as well as having not that much detail. She didn't need a lot of detail to be such a good prop, and she is one of the better Halloween props. She sells for a decent amount of money nowadays, but I don't know if I'll sell her anytime soon. I might not. We'll see. She is definitely a cool one, and I'm very happy to own her. Because she's very faulty, I'm gonna rate her probably like an 8.5 out of 10. I think her detail is very awesome, and her look is awesome. She's generally a pretty scary witch, and definitely a better witch out of the animatronic witches that have been made. So yeah, thank you for watching this video. Like, comment, subscribe, comment what you think about this girl. I wanna hear what you have to say about her, if you like her, if you hate her. I don't know. All right, please like, comment, and subscribe for more. Peace.